psychologist's favorite term is deficit. The word denotes impairment or incapacity of neurological function, loss of language, memory, vision, dexterity, identity, and the myriad of other lacks and losses of specific functions. For all these dysfunctions, another favorite term, we have privative words of every sort: aphonia, aphemia, aphasia, alexia, apraxia, agnosia, amnesia, ataxia. A word for every specific neural or mental function of which patients may find themselves deprived. Deficit. Loss. Everything that patients aren't, and nothing that they are. Such language tells us nothing about an individual's history. It conveys nothing of the person and the reality of facing disease and struggling to survive it. To restore the human subject at the center, the suffering, afflicted, fighting human subject, we must deepen a case history to a narrative or tale. Only then do we have a who as well as a what, a patient in relation to disease, a real person. Dr. P was a musician of distinction, well known for many years as a singer and then, at the local school of music, as a teacher. It was here, in relation to his students, that certain strange problems were first observed. Sometimes a student would present himself and Dr. P would not recognize him, or specifically, would not recognize his face. The moment the student spoke, he would be recognized by his voice. Such incidents multiplied, causing embarrassment, perplexity, fear, and sometimes comedy. For not only did Dr. P increasingly fail to see faces, but he saw faces where there were no faces to see.
Oh, Thank you.
Ich sah
surface that is softly enfolded, that is softly enfolded on it, on itself.
Yeah. from China, lovely fragrance. Tea from China, lovely fragrance. Tea from China, lovely fragrance. Tea from China, lovely fragrance. La 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 la.
Tell me, how does he manage? How can he get dressed or take a bath or tie a shoelace? How does he manage? This was some time ago, and often since then, I myself wondering how he comprehended the world. Put myself in his shoes, on his head, so to speak, imagined his vision. The strange loss of image, yet preserved musicality. I think that music, for him, took the place of the image. He had no body image. He had body music. And to this inner soundtrack, he moved and he acted. Fluently, cogently. But when the music stopped,